Saving your Home Assistant backups only locally on the device where Home Assistant is running is not the best option. If the storage of the device that holds your backups gets corrupted, you won't be able to access them. That is why it is a good idea to store your encrypted backups somewhere on the cloud, like on Google Drive, for example. This will be a step-by-step guide on how you can enable this Home Assistant Google Drive integration. Before we continue further, I want to share that I've made a PDF that goes with this video and you can download it for free. You will get everything that is needed with that PDF in one place with all the links and instructions in a concise and simplified way. To download the PDF, simply click the link in the description, follow this link or scan the QR code. Then you enter your name and your email address. You need to confirm your mail so that I'll know that you are not some kind of robot. And you sign up for my mailing list and the PDF will automatically download to your device. That way you've joined my free PDF club. You will automatically receive my weekly articles, news, updates and offers. It's a free service and you can unsubscribe at any time with just one click. Now, let's go into today's topic, the Home Assistant Google Drive integration. I'll open a new tab and I'll type console.cloud.google.com. This is the website that I need. You can get this link either from the video description or from the Home Assistant documentation or from my PDF. I'll click on this drop-down list right here and I'll create a new project because I don't want to reuse my existing ones. I'll create brand new project. The name of the project can be anything, but I'll type, for example, Home Assistant Google Drive. As location, I'll select an organization. This is the default value. Of course, if you wish, you can create an organization, but that's not needed. I'll click on create, and as you can see here from this bell, at the moment the project is created, and I can either select it from here by clicking on this select project button, or I can select it from my drop-down list. As you can see, the current project is this one, but I'll change it to the Home Assistant Google Drive. As a next step, I'll click on this APIs and services button and then on enable APIs and services. So I'll click on this enable APIs and I'll search here either by using this search or by scrolling down Google Drive API. I'll click on it, then I'll click on enable and I'll wait for the enabling to finish. I'm ready with that part. Then I'll go to this OAuth consent screen. I'll click on get started. I'll type a name of app here. So my project needs to have an app which should be published later. For example, HAG Drive, that's enough. My supported email, usually it's the same as my account, my Google account. I'll click on next. Here is something important. The audience should be external. Again, I should type my email and I'll click next. And finally, I have to agree with the user data policy and I'll hit on continue, then on create. It should work good. Afterwards, I'll go to audience menu and I'll publish this app. I'll click on this button right here, then on confirm. And this will go from testing to in production. This is the label that I need, in production. And that way, this app will not require often a re-authentication. Then I'll go to this navigation menu and I'll select credentials. Then I'll click on create credentials and I'll select OAuth client ID. As application type, I'll select web application. The name can be anything. For example, HA Google Drive credentials, something like that. Here is one very important step. As authorized redirect URIs, I need to add this URL. You can get it from the video description or from my PDF or from the Home Assistant documentation. myhomeassistant.io redirect OAuth. This is the full URI. And I'll click on create. As a result, I will see my client ID and client secret. I'll copy these things somewhere safe because I'm going to need them for the Home Assistant Google Drive integration. If you forgot this, you can click on this pencil or on this link right here and you'll see again your client ID and your client secret. Have in mind that if you are watching this in the future, some of these menus may have different places or different names or something different, but in general you need these five things: a new project, API enabled, redirection, URI, and credentials. Also, as a five, you need to publish this app in production, but again, this could be changed in the future a little bit. I have everything that is needed from this Google Cloud console, and I'll go to my test Home Assistant. Here, I'll click on the C button on my keyboard and I'll type integrations. I'll select navigate integrations. I'll click on add integration and I'll search for Google. I'll select it, then I'll select Google Drive. And here, as name, I can type whatever I wish. HA Google Drive. This is needed because it will go, I'll show you where it will go. Google Drive. Here, I should paste the client ID. And below that, I should paste the client secret. And that's it, I'm ready. I'll click on add. I should now select my Google profile. If you have more than one profile in Google, you should choose the one that where you create your project and app. I'll click on continue. This is a step where I should link both accounts. I should type my Home Assistant URL here. If that's not correct, you should click on pencil and you should update it. And then afterwards, you should click on link account. And success! If I open this link now in a new tab, I'll see my Google Drive and a Home Assistant folder, which is empty for now, but that will be changed soon. I can click on finish. And if I scroll down, I can see my Google Drive integration added in my Home Assistant. Before we continue further, I want to share from where you can delete these credentials if that's needed. If, for example, you unsuccessfully managed to add this integration and you want to remove everything, click on this three dots menu, application credentials, and here it is, Home Assistant Google Drive. And from here, you can delete these credentials and you can start over and try again. I'm saying this because I was in such a situation before and I forgot where these credentials were. So at this point, I have everything needed to set up my backup on Google Drive. I'll go to settings, then system, then backups, or I can just press on C and I can type backups, and then I can select navigate backups. And here on the backup settings, as you can see, the backup is only local now, but I can easily change that. If I enable this switch, the backup will be also stored on my Google Drive. And from this cogwheel button, I can turn off the encryption, but that is something that I don't want to do. And I also highly recommend to don't turn it off as well. So I'll leave as it is, and I'm ready. Now, every time when there is an automatic backup, the backups will be stored on my system where my Home Assistant is running and on my Google Drive. Let's test this. If I create a new backup now, automatic backup, creating a backup, and after some time, I'll have backup ready locally on the device where Home Assistant is running and in the cloud on my Google Drive. Good, everything is backed up, and if I go back to my Google Drive, I will see my automatic backup file uploaded and ready to be used. And this is an encrypted file. If I want to download this file unencrypted, I can go to my backups, my automatic backups. And if I click on some of these icons, I will see the backup details. And at the end, I can see the locations. And from here, I can download this backup either from my local storage or from the cloud. And if I download this from the cloud, it will be unencrypted. It will be automatically unencrypted for me, so I can use some files in it. But if I download the file from here, it will be an encrypted file. So that's the perfect scenario, and this thing is working perfectly in my opinion. Leave a comment down below. Are you going to try this Home Assistant Google Drive integration? Also, again, if you need all of the instructions, please download my PDF file and everything will be there. And you can get it for free by using these links. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.